Your rise over run means on the graph, you'd make your run and then go up for your rise. On your slope, it shows that your rise is on the top and your run is on the bottom. You do your rise over run for a graph triangle when you're going up from lattice point to lattice point. Change in y over change in x is on the graph, shown here. The x is on the bottom and the y is on the top, just like in your rise over run.
Okay, so you just have to go back.
Parallel lines. Parallel lines are when you have your line going straight, like that. Well, they don't have to go straight. They can even go like this. But they have to be like that, if you know what I'm saying. See, in parallel, it even has parallel lines in the L's. Ha ha. Perpendicular lines are when you have your lines intersect like this, shown on the graph, with the same angle. Your slope triangle is where you have your lattice point from lattice point in a triangle, your figure, shown on the graph. With your slope triangle, you can go from one lattice point to another lattice point super easily. A slope is found in your equation or on your graph. Shown here, you can find it in your equation. It's the number before the x. Or on your graph. One second here. Another second here, please. On your graph, with your line, that's your slope triangle, too. Good. The steepness of a line is just like the steepness of a hill. It's just how steep it is. On a graph, you can see how steep the graph is. It shows that a cat's height plays a big importance in a cat's weight. As a cat's height goes up, so does the cat's weight. That is the steepness. The line of best fit is where you make a line in between all the little dots you made, and it just pretty much shows your average. The rate of change is pretty much how fast the line is going.